Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Just a quick video. Just like the majority of people on both sides yesterday, I would hope, I was shocked and saddened by the events that unfolded in London yesterday. I was also angry and disappointed because we have all just played right into the hands of the elites and their government puppets who control us, because we've given them a possibility of racial tension and a possibility of civil unrest on the streets, which will bring about martial law. And that's what the government wants, because it will allow them to move on to the next part of the plan. But hopefully at the end of this video I will show you that it's not the everyday Joe on the streets' fault, the masses as we call them, because them people just go to work every day and work the butts off to put food on the table for their families. That's all they do, and they don't see colour, creed or religion. They just see fellow human beings. But I'm hoping by the end you will see that our frustration, anger and questions should all be aimed at the governments and the elites around the world. Now, this song I'm going to play now is the Isley Brothers. It's Harvest for the World. Now, these guys told us years ago about the problems in this song and how to solve them. They did a very good job. We didn't do a very good job of listening, ladies and gentlemen, but we need to unite now and start to listen, because time is indeed running out. That's exactly right, ladies and gentlemen. Half the world is in need and the other half has got plenty. But again, that's not the average person's fault. Because if you look over the last 20 odd years, especially here in the UK, we've had a thing called Children in Need, Red Nose Day. And I'm sure they do it in other countries as well. And it was all to do with, we had Band-Aid as well in the 80s, early 80s, which raised millions. And it was all down to eradicate poverty and famine in Africa. Now, myself and millions of other British people have all given to this charity. We don't see colour. We only see fellow human beings that are struggling and need help. Now, over these years, we have raised £1.2 billion, ladies and gentlemen. That's just in the UK alone. What we need to be asking the BBC, all these companies who are involved with children in need and the government, where's this £1.2 billion gone? Because it seems to me it's gone to the CEOs of these companies. Because when you look at what's happening in Africa, nothing's changed. And we've given the money, we can't deny more, we're trying to help. But these people have creamed the money, from what I can see. 1.2 billion, where's it gone? We should be asking these questions, ladies and gentlemen. Because every year it comes on, it's the same. Nothing seems to have changed. And like I said, that's not the fault of the people. It's the fault of the elites. And if you look at these elites, take two of them, just two of them for now, Elon Musk and Bill Gates. If you look at what them two are doing, they are investing millions and billions into satellites and vaccines to control us all. Now, if just them two alone donated 1% of their fortunes, as we say, because it's all come from our taxes, we could eradicate poverty and famine in Africa tomorrow. Just think about that. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, far too many of us are feeling the strain. But again, it's all for the greed from the elites and their government puppets. Because if you look what's happened over the last 5-6 months, what have they done, ladies and gentlemen? They've locked you all in your houses. They've put you all on furlough. Everybody's having to spend their own money out of the banks because they're not working. Your money's all dwindled. And then you've got people now losing their livelihoods, people now losing their jobs, people losing businesses, people now starting to lose their houses. Now let's flip the coin over. What have any of these politicians lost? Have any of them lost their houses? Have any of them been put on furlough? No. Have they all had their full wages from day one? Yes. Are they on lockdown? Not technically, no, because classed as essential workers in the legislation, they can still go about their business as they want. You really got to start waking up to what's going on here, guys, because it's not good and we're being played. All because of a virus that's a fake pandemic that's got 0.5% of killing you. 99.5 chance of surviving this virus, yet they've shut the whole world down for 0.5%. This should have red flags everywhere for you people, for everybody. Time to use your common sense, guys, please. Again, life can get better for the world, but only if we wake up to what's happening, what the system is doing to us. We vote these people in because we trust them. We give them our consent to look after our well-being. And all they're doing is trampling on our rights and our freedoms, ladies and gentlemen. That's all they're doing. And these people are exactly right, the Isley brothers. We have to unite every man, every woman. Get into lawful rebellion, Article 61, in all the Commonwealth countries. Unite as people, march peacefully and lawfully, and give the paperwork in to remove these people. Because they are not working for you. They are enslaving you. And that's not what they're there for. They're there to serve you. They work for us, not the other way around, ladies and gentlemen. And that's how it's become. We have started to become their slaves, and that's not what parliaments around the world and governments were set up for. We need to wake up. It's just basic common sense, guys. The answer is so very, very simple. exactly, ladies and gentlemen. Majority of the people on this planet are God-loving, peaceful people. That's what they are. Whatever religion you follow, you're peaceful people, usually. It's only the minority in all that's causing all these problems, along with the elites and the governments. Now, Antifa have been infiltrating all sides of this. All sides, not just Black Lives Matter. They've infiltrated the right as well. And they are the ones who are getting us to fight each other when they come on the demos, because they infiltrate and start the trouble. We should be grabbing out of these people and giving them to the police. That's what you should be doing, because they are damaging what we want to achieve. Because these people, Antifa, along with the left, are all Marxist people. They're all Marxists. They want communism everywhere. And trust me, if you look at the past with communism, we should learn from our history. Look at what happened in the Soviet Union in 1918 when they killed the Tsar. They're just murderers. They just control everything. You are slaves. If you don't go along with what they want, they just murder you out the way. You've got no rights, no freedoms, anything under communism, ladies and gentlemen. And Antifa and the left, you're playing right into the hands. And the government, the government. There's no such thing as a left and right government anymore. They're all in it together. Politics is dead. You're not going to win anything by voting. You're only going to win by uniting together, no matter what colour creed you are, men and women, like it says in this song, and going down there lawfully and peacefully and sorting the problem. Because by fighting each other, you're just eliminating each other, making sure there's less and less to fight back. And then when they bring all the communism in, everybody will lose these rights. So you might be fighting for rights now, you've been promised. But when these, just look at communism. Nobody ends up with rights, only the state who are running things. Please, guys, wake up. Because time is running out. Let's do it for our children. We shouldn't want our children fighting each other on the streets. We should want our children to grow up in a peaceful, harmonising world. But the elites and the government puppets and Antifa want to change the compass. They want to change things and bring in a communism state everywhere. Please wake up, guys. It's our last chance. Exactly. Talking about the children. Think, guys. Don't keep getting played. Think for yourselves, guys, because it's the only thing that's going to save humanity. The road we're going down now is the road to destruction. Well, that's it, guys. I'll speak to you all soon. Have a great day. Hopefully be on later with Nathan, if I can get out of him. I love every single one of you. It doesn't matter what colour or creed you are, or religion, as long as you believe in humanity and you want everybody to have a good life and not live under communism, then we are halfway there. Speak to you soon, guys. Take care.